Hey, Fez Watley back in today. Fez, how are you?
Good, buddy.
You feel all right? His mic sounds way different to mine. We had gigantic mic problems on Friday, too, where large pockets of the XM Nation either couldn't hear me or the callers. So, does that sound okay to you, Earl?
How does it sound, Earl? Oh, it sounds awful to me.
Yeah, you sound very tinny.
Yeah.
You sound okay, just need to juice you up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Juice me up a bit.
Then you go ahead and do that.
I think he's trying to come on to me.
You know, I wonder why, like, when I watch Letterman, I never see him going, what's wrong with these cameras? How come the cameras aren't set up properly?
Is Paul Schaefer's mic off?
You know, no one ever asked the host in TV to start directing the TV show as it's going on. These are questions I'm talking to you about, Earl.
No, I mean, again, it was just a situation that, you know, we were just trying to do a lot of things at once, trying to make sure everything worked okay. And
what did you try to make sure worked okay?
You know, make sure that the hookups were right as far as, you know, being connected to the proper studio.
There was no replay, right? You knew that.
Actually, this room was live. This room, they were running the replay out of this room, so we couldn't do a lot of tests.
The instant replay, you idiot.
Oh, the instant replay, I'm sorry. We were trying to find connector cables to make sure that worked okay. All right.
And yet, no one brought that up until 5 minutes before the show when I said it, and then everyone went and got connector cables. So I don't know what would have happened.
That was brought up to me when I walked in, and that was a situation, again, we were trying to rectify.
You know what you ought to get is one of those clipboards that has everything that you need to do, and then as you accomplish each thing, you could check it off.
Yes, I was attempting to do that, but it didn't work out.
What were you attempting to do? Go to Best Buy, pick up some stuff? What were you how did the attempts go awry?
No, I mean, things were assumed that were wrong. And now,
yeah, but if you had the clipboard, you'd be able to go, okay, do I have an instant replay? Do I have computers or Fez? You know? And then you click them off one at a time.
Yes, you're correct.
I should have told you about this before, shouldn't I have?
No, not at all. I mean, this is something I should have been very well aware of. And again, that was things I was trying to rectify before the show. I was like, okay, these are the things that they need. And again, it was just getting completely sidetracked.
The one piece of equipment he knows works is the snack machine. That is working perfectly.
I came in here today and I saw everyone in a blind panic. Literally in a panic. Like, you did not know that Wiki had this, you know, was doing this build out with the other studio for a long time.
No, I was very well aware of it, but again, just things kind of went crazy.
Why would they go crazy? You've had a month.
I can understand how that whole show open thing catches you off guard after almost 2 years.
Yeah, how did that grab you, where we do the exact opposite show opening?
That'll sneak up on you.
Earl?
Well, again, I was like, okay, let me load the show opening, but there were matters that were supposedly more pressing that I had to absolutely take care of at that moment.
More pressing than the start of the show.
That's what I said. That's exactly what I said.
Who are you saying this to? Who are these people? Is it God?
Oh, Lord.
Who could pull you away from your job?
Again, I was told, I was like, they need your attention. It has to be done
right
now.
Who is they? I want some specific names, Earl.
Well, Dave. Dave was saying, this has to be done right now. This has to be taken care of.
What was it that Dave couldn't do?
Honestly, I don't know. He was like, you need to talk to the guys. We are having a problem with the instant replays. And I went, well, I have to take care of this now. Mm-hmm. And he was like, this can wait.
I didn't see you in here working on the replay.
Well, I was trying to grab one of the engineers just to see what the situation was.
So, right now, if you had to put the blame on anybody, it would be Dave?
Well, specifically for the opener, yes, that would be Dave.
Okay. Hey, Matt, whoops. Let's see where. Matt, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Miss Pre-Employed Earl.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I just wanted to say everything sounds fine on the air. You're coming through fine.
All right, thank you very much, brother. I appreciate it. Here's Paul. Paul, you're on Fez.
1-867, buddy.
Yeah, what do you say, pal?
Hey, I mean, I like Earl and everything, but if there was a place kicker in the NFL and he just attempted to do his job and not do it, he wouldn't have one. So how does Earl...
Hold on. What if that place kicker was the only black guy on the team?
I guess you'd have to keep him.
Good. Perfect. All right, 866 Ron Zero Fez. 866 Ron Zero Fez. Here is Peter. Peter, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, you're the best. Fez, good to hear you back, buddy.
Thanks, pal.
Ronnie, at this point, this is just making you look bad. This kid's a fuck-up.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to get rid of him.
Yeah, but here's the other point, too. It's karma. I've lived a horrible life, and this is my punishment. As a matter of fact, I have the feeling I've been dead for 10 years. If I had to guess, I'm like Tim Robbins in whatever that crazy post-Vietnam movie was. And I've been dead for 10 years, and this is my punishment. Here is Richard. Richard, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, Ronnie, what's going on?
Yeah.
Hey, maybe I don't pay close enough attention to the show, but I thought Earl was Dave's boss. And
yeah.
Now you've got Dave telling Earl what to do? Is that what's happening?
Yeah, it would be very hard for me to understand what it's like to have one of your subordinates stop you from doing your job because they were making a mess. Wouldn't you be yelling at those guys, Earl, and straightening them out?
Yes, under normal circumstances, yes. But when I'm being told, he's like, you know, you need to talk to the guys immediately. I mean, it has to be taken care of.
Then, Earl, will you do something about this Dave situation? Is it time for a suspension? Do we cancel the wedding?
Do we stop this power trip he's on?
Do you feel like Dave really, really isn't working out here?
Well, I mean, as far as the wedding, I mean, I think... I don't know. I don't know what the situation is with this wedding. I really don't.
What do you mean you don't know what the situation is? The executive producer.
No, well, let me rephrase that. I'm just saying, as far as the wedding, I mean, I wouldn't cancel the wedding. Not yet. But, you know,
Is shit going to roll downhill? Are you going to get your staff together?
Yes, I will.
And what are you going to do about it? Is somebody's ass going to be either fired or suspended for today? That the little shit studio wasn't set up. By the way, I don't know how the folks in Frank's place do it.
No.
This is like the old 1950s, how many people you fit into a phone booth. And for anybody under the age of 25, a phone booth is a place that used to have to go before cell phones. I don't know why, but Superman would change there. What are you going to do to him, Earl?
We're going to have a nice long talk after the show.
Why a long talk? Why can't you make a move?
It's not a matter of making a move. It's just there's some things I just want to say and things that need to be addressed, and I'll address them after the show.
Earl, who puts together the openings for you?
Pepper.
So all you had to do was hit play. That was the only responsibility you had left, right?
Yes, but we had it in a different format. Usually you have an audio format and a WAV format. We had it in a WAV format, and I was going to load it through the WAV format. And that's when I got sidetracked, and then we couldn't get
by.
In.
By who?
By Dave.
What did Dave want again?
He just told me that I needed to speak to them immediately.
To who?
To you and Fez.
So you didn't speak to us immediately. You talked to us 5 minutes before the show started.
Long before it was time for you to push that one button, George Jetson.
Wave. So that was 5 minutes before, right?
Yes.
And plus, as the executive producer of the show, don't you want to talk to the host every day before the show?
Oh, of course.
He's shy.
Were you not going to then if Dave didn't come in?
No, I had every intention of doing that. But again, there was just so many things going on. It wasn't no disrespect to you guys at all. But again, there was a lot going on. And
but what happened in the 5 minutes that you had since you came slinking in here, staring at your shoes and shallow breathing and the star of the show? What happened then?
Again, I didn't mean it that way. I was just, again, there was so many things going on, and I had to take care of so many things before the show started, and I wasn't in a panic. I was just concerned.
But what happened in the 5 minutes that you had to hit the play button?
Again, we were having some trouble loading one of the CDs, and that's, again, that was a problem I was trying to take care of. I was like, okay, why is this thing not loading properly?
So that seems far away from the Dave problem, though.
Yes, but I was in the midst of taking care of that. That's when I got called
away.
What
is he talking about, Fez?
I don't know. Apparently he was trying to load a CD into Dave, and that's where the problems all started.
Here is, let me go to Brian. Brian, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, in this day and age, you have, Lily is a Muslim, is she not?
Yes, she is.
Well, I think, aren't they Lily and Earl kind of interchangeable on the equal opportunity scale now? Couldn't you drop Earl and still be okay because you employ Lily?
Very good question. Earl, would you be willing to step down for Lily?
No, I would not be willing to step down for Lily. Hmm. Not at all.
Would you be willing to get rid of Dave for Lily?
Dave for Lily? That's very intriguing. That's a very, very good proposition, but that's the one I have to think about.
You can't think. You got to go. We're on the air now. I can't tell people, please check back in here 7 hours from now for the rest of the show.
If I had to swap out Dave for Lily, I would say no.
Hmm. Dave for Pepper.
Dave for Pepper? Yeah, I would swap a Pepper for Dave.
So why aren't you doing that if you're the executive producer? Why aren't you trying to put together the best team possible for Ron and Fez?
No, I will. I mean, it's just, it's not something that, I mean, it's something I would do in a heartbeat and then would do, but I got to go through proper channels.
So is that what you're planning on doing?
Yes, it's something I definitely want to do.
You're going to put the paperwork in motion to get rid of Dave.
Yeah.
And bring in Pepper Hicks.
Well, good news for you, Pepper Hicks. Congratulations. as soon as the paperwork goes through, you're in.
There's been a case study done, apparently, and now the paperwork's being filed.
This is what I always wanted, guys.
Sure. Hey, welcome aboard. Welcome aboard. Personally, I feel like you've been shanghaied.
Hope you don't get caught up in all that red tape for Earl's paperwork filing.
Here is Bill. Bill, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, let me get this straight, Ron. You were there 5 minutes before the show.
Yeah, I really was today because I caught a cab.
did you just know that Earl was going to fuck up?
Well, I knew that I knew Fez was coming back, so I knew I'd be seeing pie-eyed. And then also I knew that we were in this other shit studio, Frank's Place, as they call it.
Frank should have a bigger place.
Frank's actual coffin is bigger than this. Steve just came by and is laughing at us. It really is. It really feels like play radio. Like it's not real radio.
Yeah, we got an old refrigerator box, and we're pretending that's our radio studio.
Here's Ron. Ron, you're on the Fez.
Yeah, do you ever get tired of taking 30 minutes out of every day to explain to Earl what he's not doing?
You know, I think it's, the funny thing is, it's far more because you're not listening off the air. Off the air, it's even worse. And then we have to go, Wiki has this conversation with him. Elo would, but Earl hides from him.
I don't call it hiding.
What would you call it, Earl?
Hiding.
Witness protection.
Who is your dream team right now? Tell me the truth. Are you, now, you tell me on the air that you're going to try to replace Hicks with Dave. And what a better time for Dave to get fired. It's just as he's getting married. But when is this all taking place? Or is this just something you say on the air to deflect responsibility for yourself?
No, I mean, it's something that will happen after the show today. I'll make a phone call. I'll shoot an email. This thing is going to happen.
Good. And it's going to happen why? Because he asked you a question before the show? What are your reasons going to be?
I mean, honestly, there's a lot of reasons. I'm like, sometimes I always try to tell him, it's like, Dave, you're part of the show too. Sometimes I need help too. Sometimes
right.
I need, you know.
So when are you writing out the email? When can we expect the email before you send it to Wiki?
After the show.
I want it before. I want you to be able. Why don't you switch out with Pepper right now, and then you write up the email, the actual email that you're going to send to Wiki.
I want the subject heading to be, my God, I'm only one man.
I'm fucking serious about this, Earl. I really want you to do it, and I want to be able to read the email, okay?
All right.
All right, so switch out. I think 15 minutes is enough time to put the email together. Does that sound like enough for you?
Yeah, that's enough time for me.
All right, so 15 minutes from right now. Now, I won't be able to tell because I don't have a clock in here. In the year 2007, my show has not mastered time. So I just feel like I'm going to have to guess 15 minutes from now. So, Hicks, this is exciting news for you. Best of luck.
This is fucking great.
Yeah, I know. What was the opening going to be today?
High fidelity into 13th floor elevators.
Mm. The kid's always thinking.
Yeah, that would have been great.
Yeah.
I would have loved to have heard that.
Sure. Here's Rocky. Rocky, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, I just want to know if Earl publicly apologized to O&A yet.
Right now, Earl is firing Dave as we speak. It's I'm going to make him send this out, too. This is going to be the boy who cried wolf. I am going to teach Earl a lesson by getting Dave fired today. That's my new management style.
Earl right now is writing up an email that he's going to send off to his supervisor, Wiki, complaining that it's time for Dave to go. An official email that'll end up in Dave's files.
Johnny, you're around a Fez.
Hi, boys. How are you? I was thinking of coming by today, but since you're in the other closet, I don't think I could fit with you.
You are always welcome. What we could do is run a cord out to you as you stand in the street.
I like that. I mean, that's probably going to have to do it. I got to tell you, the show that's going to be broadcasting out of that studio from 6 to 10 on the Boneyard, that guy's not going to be happy. He's never happy anyway.
Well, I just looked at the capacity that the fire department set up here. It's two. So only two people before they'll come in and shut us down. Who's the Boneyard guy tonight?
Trunk.
Yeah, but I hope that... Trunk has on his show some band, so like nine of them have to force their way into here.
I mean, him and his head alone.
Yeah.
That's going to be a bad scene. So
that's ego, really.
Am I canceling this wedding now or something?
If Dave is fired, we're going to have to cancel the wedding.
Well, we can just do a regular show then.
Yeah.
And everyone gets some free appetizers.
Well, really, what I would like to have is just the space. So just to do a regular show off your stage would be great. I'm guessing we've got about another 6-7 minutes before Earl comes in here and lets us read the email that he's sending out to Don Wiki Wicklin. This is going to send a shock through XM programming since they just sunk a lot of money into Dave's wedding.
Yeah, and just a few days before it's to be held at the Hard Rock, Dave could be out.
Jeff, you're on Running Fez.
Hey, I tell you what, Dave gets fired, the show's dead to me. You're firing the wrong person. You need to get rid of Fez.
Why don't we do this, Jeff? When we fire, why would we get rid of Fez?
Because Fez don't like showing up to work. Something's always going on with him.
What if we do this? If we fire Dave, why don't you show up here, one-man protest, and run over your XM radio in a truck? Mm-hmm. Out front.
Sure will.
Yeah.
See ya.
All right, take care.
Person.
So there you have it. The backlash has started against us, where basically Fez and I are becoming the most hated men in radio. We will stand. This may be a situation for the PAC. If I look out there and I see one person breaking a radio, I might panic. I might panic and call Dave back in. I don't know at this point.
Well, this could be the first time someone has been fired for asking questions. So we'll see exactly what happens here.
So you're saying he doesn't deserve to be fired?
No, I say no.
I disagree. I mean, you cannot, before the show, pull the show down by bringing up things that don't matter. You can't be... you're saying it's okay to ask questions. I'm not going to let the interns come in and ask me questions now while I'm on the air. Well, Earl was in the hot seat.
I can understand that, but I think all responsibility eventually flows to Earl.
Here's Tom. Tom, you're on Running Fez.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
You know that theory about the ripple effect of a butterfly's wing?
Causing a hurricane on the other side of the earth?
Exactly. Can you imagine how different life would have been if Earl had just pushed that button and played the opening?
I honestly think that the Iraq War would have turned around for us. I think enough things would have been put into play that maybe we'd be finding peace in the Middle East right now. Jeremy, you're on Running Fez.
What's up, Ronnie?
Yeah.
Hey, if they shit-can that dumb red-headed fuck, I think the rider should step back in.
You know, we have not seen the rider in some time. I'd love to see the rider show up at the wedding. Who knows, though? Who knows? Maybe there won't be a wedding. The butterfly effect is in effect right now. Here's Fake Riley. How are you?
What's up, buddies? Hey, yeah. Why don't all the interns and Dave, why don't they band together and demand that Earl gets run off? They strengthen numbers.
Well, the last intern revolution did not go on to day two. That's the problem with the intern revolution. They don't stick with it.
And we are about 3 minutes now from Earl having his email completed.
Rob, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
Hey, I would fire Earl because that's his job to keep everything coordinated. That's not Eastside Dave's job.
Well, when Dave is fired, I suggest that you show up here outside of XM, run over your radio with a truck, and we'll fold like an omelet. That's my prediction. I wouldn't mind getting Deb on this. Letting her do a little something. I haven't seen her on TV lately. I'd like to see her sitting on Nightline going, how can Dave, by asking a question, bring down the show? And apparently you got Fez on your side now.
There'd be some sort of ginger help coming in.
T-Bone, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
2 minute warning, Ronnie. 2 minute warning, and that idiot has to be back with the email.
2 minutes before we get to read the email, and I'm going to make this, I'm going to honestly make him send it to Wiki in Caravillo that he is asking for a regime change. I love it.
Wiki doesn't even know this is coming. He thinks he's having a normal business day.
I love the fact that Earl's. This should be a normal business day for Wiki. He should be sitting there backing up one of his producers. Earl has the right to put together the team that he needs to make this little closet radio show a success. I love it back here. It's comfy. It's cozy. I feel like by the time we come out of here, out of this cocoon, we will be butterflies. In fact, that's going to be... We came in here as a couple of caterpillars. We're leaving as beautiful butterflies. That's the butterfly effect.
Just to spread our wings.
Mike, you're on Fez.
I just got a whack bag.
Yeah.
It's Dave fired. I'm going to punch my endo and put it on YouTube.
Just let's see how this all plays out. No one panic. I'm willing to offer people a month free if we fire Dave. Give us a chance. You haven't heard the new show. Rick, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, listen, I am so tired of cop-out Earl and his bullshit whining, poisoning my ears. You need a real producer in there. Get Bernie McGurk.
You know what? First of all, give Earl the opportunity. I see Earl hanging out front. Bring him in to me, will you, Nico? Bring me Earl. Yes, you can't hear me at all, can you? So the guy who's standing outside that's going to be my runner can't hear the show. Earl, do you have your letter?
Yes, I do.
And will this be sent out?
Yes, it will.
Have you sent it yet?
No, I haven't, because I just wanted to make sure I was cool with you guys.
Mm-hmm.
As I always do, I check everything with you.
All right, here we go. Don. I would like to recommend that we replace David McDonald with Pepper Hicks, effective immediately. Since coming aboard as an intern, Pepper has brought a great passion and energy to the show. He's constantly coming in with ideas that have worked for the show on and off the air. I don't need ideas off the air, so I would probably correct that one point. As a matter of fact, he's decided that Ron should make some changes at home.
Sounds like he has lunch ideas.
And he's willing to give us his time, no matter how long, to any project. Dave has been terrific on air, but has lacked the administrative skills that are needed to make the show go to the next level. If you'd like to discuss this at length, please feel free to call me Love Earl. Let me just point this out, Earl. You never want to write Love Earl in a business email. All right. Fez, you got any problems with this?
Well, I think one problem is when you're trying to get rid of somebody, why call them terrific at one point during the email?
Well, he's being honest. He's saying he's terrific on air.
Yeah.
You know, as a character, personally, I think he's derailed the show with Wedding Talk. Derailed the show with Wedding Talk. And you know where I got that?
Where?
Milkman Dan, he IM'd me the other night, I believe drunk, to let me know that that we've lost the hardcore whack bag people.
No, I just thought it was a very, you know, short to the point. I mean, I didn't want to...
Although he's good at one part of his job,
yeah,
he's not able to do the full job.
Yeah, because I didn't want to make it look like, you know, I'm being vindictive or just, you know, making it really personal.
Right.
I mean, I'm being professional.
You know what I love, too? You never used the term whitey at any point. I think if you would have said cracker or whitey, this would have made it look like it was personal.
Yeah, that would have taken that letter into a different direction.
My dearest Don, as summer rolls across the country, I find myself writing you in the dearest of straits. Pepper, this okay with you? Can you hear us, Pepper? Because we got people in the other room, and we really don't even know.
Yeah, I guess that's fine.
Yeah.
But I also would like him to use my real name and not Pepper Hicks.
This is your real name now, son.
Oh, okay.
The odd thing is the guy, and I hate your name, by the way, but you got the name by the guy who's getting fired so you can have his job.
This is great. I love it.
And Pepper is your guy, not Lily. Lily, who's been here longer? Lily hasn't done shit, has she?
You know, she was a great help with the with the big ass bash.
Yeah,
but you know, Pepper's just been on fire.
Why don't you write in that you would have chose Lily, but in your view, she's a cock tease.
I don't think that would have gone over very well.
All right, I got a problem right now already. The PAC is calling the show. Everybody, be very careful around this. Hello, Deb.
Hello.
Yes.
I was wondering, first of all, sup. Start up a new Save Dave campaign again?
The last time that happened, I got to see some topless women, which I liked very much. Yeah, maybe if FBA would just roll out a bunch of topless women, or bottomless, maybe then I'd be willing to go over Earl's head on this. I don't know.
I got to wonder, though, Earl's not really using very good team-building techniques here. If he doesn't get his way, where does it leave the team?
Yeah, if you don't succeed, your team is in shambles, Earl.
Well, I look at it as, you know what, if you can't...
You don't feel like this is knee-jerk just to protect yourself from when you were getting in trouble at the start of the show?
No, I'm just explaining what happened. I'm just explaining the situation. I'm trying to make the situation better, and I kept getting cut off at the knees.
How can they work together after this?
But HCG, for once, can't you back up the black point of view? Just once, can't the PAC get behind black people?
Where's the black point of view?
Earl.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
And why don't you get rid of Dave?
Who couldn't be further than black than snow.
That's why I was confused.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. For once, let's see the PAC get behind Earl.
Well, you know, I can't get behind Earl if he's trying to fire Dave.
Yeah. I see.
I think you got a knee-jerk reaction here. Earl,
Why don't you do this?
You really got to be careful.
Why don't you and Pat from Monarchy run over a couple XM radios and we'll panic and we'll drop this thing.
That should settle it.
All right?
Maybe there's something else we can run over.
You know what? I would do this. Get that FBA skin coming my way. And maybe then, you know... I'll start and change my mind. I don't know what else to do. I do not know what else to do.
All right, well, we'll have the Save Dave campaign up and running this afternoon.
I'm worried the writer's going to end up marrying Casey, and I think that's going to make everything look bad at the wedding.
Yeah, I don't want to see that happen.
And I don't want to see Dave go walking out of here with his hurricane lamps.
I think you need E-Rock to come in.
Oh, E-Rock would never be able to fit in this room. We are snug right here now. Earl just walked in. And we're literally penis to penis in this room. It's tummy sticks. All right, honey.
Thanks, Ron. Bye.
All right, bye-bye. All right, are you ready to hit send on this?
Yeah, if it's cool with you guys, I'll hit the send.
Oh, it's more than cool with me. I want to be there later. To hear the phone call that you get.
Oof. It's always...
Yeah.
Always an interesting conversation.
I don't even know what Pepper Hicks' real name is. Do you?
Yeah, I do.
Write it down for me.
I don't.
You haven't met the interns yet, Fez.
No. I can guess what he looks like.
By the way, Nico's real name?
Uh-huh.
Douglas Fairbanks the Fourth.
Really?
Yeah.
Why change to Nico?
This sounds like a bass player. That's not a name. That's a 1980s bass player.
Yeah, Pepper Hicks has just a beautiful ring to it.
Pepper Hicks is the dumbest name in the world. This guy, he gave up a show business name. Should I say what it is?
Sure.
Give it out.
Yeah, you can say it.
Pepper Hicks' real name is Todd Hillier.
What?
Which, to me, works perfectly for the air.
I can see why he changed it now.
Too gay?
Too stupid.
No, I'm asking you.
Oh.
You too gay? Here is... let me go to Aaron. Hammer and Hank, you're on the Ron and Fez show. How are you, buddy?
Hey, Aaron, what's up?
Yeah.
Man, hey, Ron, what's up?
Yeah.
Hey, I just want to say you got some fucking nerve trying to get rid of Dave after he's fucking stood by Ron and Fez and after the fucking travesty you created for last month. You need to fucking get fucking die, Earl.
Do you have to work blue, Aaron?
What's that?
Do you have to work blue? Can you express yourself without profanity?
Oh, sorry about that, Ron.
All right.
Much respect to you and Fez, but come on, Earl.
Come on, show some respect. We don't run a potty mouth show.
Sorry about that, Ron.
All right, see. Jay, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Dick Holder, 723.
What do you say, my brother?
Should Earl be making changes to the show when Thursday will be his last day when Ron Wood won't be booked?
How do you know Ron Wood won't be at the wedding?
Because Earl's in charge of it.
I believe Ron Wood will be there. Don't you, Earl?
Oh, of course. I have every intention of having a stone on these airwaves by Thursday.
But wouldn't it be fantastic to have Ron Wood just show up at the wedding? And by stone, why Ron Wood? No, one of the other ones. You know, Ron Wood's a fantastic artist.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Maybe he could draw Casey and Dave.
That would be nice. I mean, his artwork's displayed all over the world. It's fantastic. And, you know, have Dave, you highlight the red in Dave's hair. And
an original Wood as their wedding gift.
But, yeah, I mean, I have every intention of having a Rolling Stone on these airways by Thursday.
Where the hell is my phone? I heard a beep.
Be a nice wedding surprise. So, yeah, you said you would get a stone. I guess you decided it specifically would be Ron Wood. By the first day of summer.
June 21st, the first day of summer.
I have the Save Dave nip pickup in the Pal Talk room. And this is the one day I don't have Pal Talk. And Frenchie's got the nips out. Oh, this is a travesty today. I can't deal like this. Let's go with Larry. Larry, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, guys. You know, I love Pepper Hicks as much as the next guy. But there's a guy named Guy Geyerson waiting in the wings who's talking sports.
I think Guy Geyerson's starting to catch on a little bit. I really do. Did you think I was going to hit you? You're like a dog that's afraid. I made a movement and Earl almost dove on the ground.
He cowered.
You're like a beat dog, Earl.
Yeah, I mean, that's something back when I was growing up with my father, that whole deal. Oh, by the way, I got baby pictures, by the way.
Oh, I love to see them.
Yeah, I got one from me. It's like 2 days old.
I had them bring in baby pictures last week. Dave's are hysterical. He looks like the most adorable ADD kid in the world. Pitsy's thing was the saddest. He was a 5-year-old Pitsy, looking and acting the same way that he looks today.
Little fire hydrant.
Yeah. Yesterday I sent some emails out to the boys and I said, make sure everyone calls your father, except for Pitsy, because he ain't got no dad.
That really brightened my day up, Ron. Thank you.
Did that help you?
Yeah, it did, actually.
Are you going to miss your buddy, Dave?
Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do without him, really.
Well, now you got your new buddy.
Pepper Hicks?
Lane Stanley. here is... I don't have your name. It's a funny day today. You're on the Ron and Fez show. How are you?
How are you guys?
Good.
How are you guys today? I just wanted to say that I'm a supporter of all of you guys and also Obi Anthony, and I'm a big fan of Black Earl, but I'm willing to come down there and run over my radio for Dave.
Well, contact the PAC with that. It's the only way to go about it. Because you don't want to run over your radio without being on TV.
Yeah, it defeats the whole purpose of it.
I understand. I was just had sent to me. XM phones just tied up. There's been already two callers about if Dave's fired, they are going to quit.
The receptionist is in the weeds.
But right now, the operator's on it. They offer you a lollipop, and once you get that, you won't want to, you know, hey, I'll send you a lollipop. Oh, fuck it then. The hell with Dave. Should we give Dave an opportunity to give his side of the story or no? Or are you going to send out no matter what he has to say?
I'll send it out no matter what.
Yeah. All right. So I don't see Dave around attempting to defend himself today either. That's his fault.
No, you would think he would want to get ready for arbitration or something.
Yeah. Well, I know. Who's the shop steward? Are we a union shop?
I don't know who our shop steward is.
We're not
a union.
We're not union. Here's Bobby. Bobby, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, I believe he called him Gatoots.
Look, here's the beauty. Dave wants to say why he's a good employee, right? He's standing at the door knowing that he can't use a mic, not realizing in his non-producing head there's another mic over at Pepper Hicks, but he doesn't know how to think on his feet. And Nico is giving him, the intern is going to head back here. Nico, I like it. You're working the door and nobody gets through for you. Nico, you got those little things to write down. Write down Nico's doing a good job and hand it to yourself. Bobby, what is it?
I believe Tony called him Gagoots.
No, what's that?
He called AJ Gagoots.
I can't hear you. Phones are terrible, too. It's just the hideous day around here. All right, Dave is on a microphone right now. Dave?
Yes, hi.
Nice to finally have you come to the show.
Okay.
Rough day for you today?
Yeah, it's a real rough day when your boss, your executive producer, is a lying fucking son of a bitch.
All right, now, can I tell you something right now?
What?
That is a fireable offense to me.
Okay, well then.
And Earl, I don't know why you put up with that.
Who says I'm putting it up? Why do you think I'm sending an email?
But that's not the first time he talked about you that way. You have not come back in here in a professional manner, Dave. And I would say this straight to the PAC, that is not the way a person who's on the bubble should be acting.
But he's not telling you anything that's true. First of all, about the opening, we can always put the opening in a CD player and play it. So the whole reason why he was trying to load it into Delete was because he was avoiding talking to you guys because he thought he was in trouble today.
Why did you think you were in trouble?
I didn't think at all.
Absolutely.
The studio wasn't set up?
First of all, when I walked in, you kept asking me to load the song into Delete.
I didn't say that at all. That's A. B, how about on a day where we really need you, maybe a day where, you know, everyone else was here early, maybe you don't come in at 11:30.
Come in at 11:30. That is not true.
What time did he come
in? I came at 5 after 11.
Earl, we did not see you till 11:30, unless you were hiding somewhere.
Look who it is. It's 2-1.
Wait, and his new thing is also...
Earl, did you hear what Pitsy's doing?
Yes, he's trying to throw me under the bus.
You believe that Pitsy should be on that?
I would put his name on there as well. Why not clean house?
Well, who's taking my spot, Earl?
Maybe you could put Lily in that.
Hey, Earl, you should also be putting yourself on that list, being that Ron Woods... more than likely, will not show up. And if Ron Woods shows up, I will leave.
Up to you. It's up to Wiki, whether you leave or not.
And I think Don will see that he's had a lot less problems with me and is someone who is more of a team player, who is willing to
communicate.
Earl, are you
going to go push then?
Yeah, I'll push then.
Go ahead and go push it.
All right.
Push it, because he's not a team player. He's all about Earl Douglas. He doesn't do things for the radio show. How about the summer of Earl? Or how about when he was supposed to get a date?
What's that got to do with your job? That's none of your business.
What it has to do with is he doesn't communicate at all, and then he makes up excuses lies.
Oh, Dave, when I try to delegate, you run from responsibility.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You completely run from responsibility.
Tell me.
When you were like, hey, the guys need to talk to you right now, I was like... Dave, I need to deal with this right now.
I was talking. You didn't. You could have played the CD. You could have.
So where was the CD, Dave?
You had it in your hand.
Yeah. It wasn't a CD that you could play on a CD.
We had both mixes, Earl. We had an MP3 and a wave.
So where was it, Dave?
It was you and Pepper do the openings. You and Pepper do the openings every day. How am I supposed to know?
Listen to the way you're screaming, Dave.
Dave, you're getting a little irrational. You need to calm down.
You're making me irrational, Poppy. I'm not going to apologize.
Go ahead, send.
Now, in this email, have I been nothing but professional?
You have been. Go ahead, send.
You called
me. And I'd actually put Pitsy on the bubble if I was you, for feeling like he needs to jump in, because you have to take control of this.
And I'm taking control of it. If I have to clean house, I'll clean house.
Great. You're Clint Eastwood all of a sudden. But you know what? Clint Eastwood at least faced people and talked to them.
Hey, the one thing that you always throw in my face, everyone's like, but you're the executive producer. I'm making an executive decision.
Great, make it. Make it. Because, you know what, at least you're doing something rather than skirting your responsibility.
Hey, Dave, I'm telling you right now, if Wiggy takes this serious and he plays this back, you're fucking gone. You are gone.
I understand that, but at the same time, I can't let Earl just send people...
Because now you're acting schoolyard instead of professional.
I'm trying to be professional, but Earl gets me into a rage when he just says lies. I mean,
Earl, do you think this is a race matter? Do you think that they don't respect you over racial reasons?
That could be very possible. I mean, they have this... You know, I've heard a couple of things thrown about in the office that could be implied a certain way, but I always let it roll off my back.
You impressed with Fez and I? We don't see race. We're the only show in radio with a black executive producer.
That is true. You
Branch Rickey's. We're a couple of Branch Rickey's.
Pioneers.
Yeah.
I mean, but you guys,
see one black face on that whole ONA staff?
Not a one.
Would help them, though. They should have one of everybody. Every minority should be on that staff for when the trouble hits. I go, what are you talking about? Look, we got a Jewish guy right here. Next is a black guy. That ONA staff should look like Star Trek. It really should.
Would help them out big time.
That's why we have a black, we have a Muslim, we got Nico, half Jewish.
It's like the UN of radio.
It really is as nice as we can get it. We got Fez and that whole ever-growing high money minority.
He's also He's also Canadian.
That's not really a minority. Canadian is just another word for white.
Really?
The Canadians blend in too easily.
Chuck, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, that memory pill.
Yeah.
Why don't you guys slip Dave, Eastside Dave, or maybe even Earl that pill? That way they just kind of forget that they even have to show up there.
I would take it just to forget the show today. Exactly. That would be my belief.
It's problem solved.
All right. All right, there you have it. Earl, why don't you go over, you hit send, and come back and tell us when it's sent out. All right?
All right.
Best of luck to you. Thanks. Is Pitsy going to be part of this, or are you going to deal with him separately?
I'll deal with him separately.
Nice move.
Again, not to look vindictive or, spiteful.
You've been nothing but professional, my friend.
Thank you. I try to be.
You've been nothing but professional. And Dave has sounded like a wild man today.
Yeah, he came in screaming, called me, I won't even repeat what he called me.
I want to end up against Deb on one of those split screens on Nightline. By the way, I call any news show Nightline. I don't care what it is. All right, go over and hit send. Wiki's going to be dealing with this today. John Black Rage. By the way, put it at the bottom, this is Black Rage. And then also put Ron's like Branch Rickey. And Fez is like a lime Ricky.
Delicious.
Never tasted one. Too straight. Here is Chad. Chad, you're on Fez.
I just want to know what happened over the weekend that fucking made Earl so great.
He's fantastic. He's a rising star right now. And this gives me the opportunity I've been looking at for a long time, and that's taking on the PAC. Just going head-to-head with them on Nightline. I can't wait. I cannot wait.
It may be another show other than Nightline. Maybe a different show other than Nightline.
What are you talking about, Fez?
It could be one of the CNN shows or something as well.
Remember what I said a few moments ago?
Yeah.
Call every show Nightline.
Right.
As soon as Earl gets back here, we will find out if he hits send and what Wiki's going to do about it. I think Dave shit the bed today. I think him coming back in here, screaming, using profanity, dropping the N-bomb, I think he went too far.
Well, yeah, if it ends up where he has to defend himself, in front of Wiki or Elo or something.
It's already on tape.
Yeah.
If this gets in front of arbitration, he sounds like a maniac.
I don't recall using the N-bomb.
Well, you brought up lip size, which personally, and nostril size.
Right, but that's not the N-bomb. Thank you.
To me, it is. If anything is slightly, here's another thing like I do with Nightline. If anything is slightly racist, I call it the N-bomb, no matter what it happens to be. If someone says, hey, he's a good dancer, for me, that's like hearing the N-word.
That's a whole deck of race cards.
What is?
Just referring to everything as the N-bomb.
You ever go back to, by the way, here's other problems we have, and I had this sent to me from RMPGP, from Whackbag. Whackbag, home of my favorite thread in the history of the internet, and that's Ron Bennington's line of the day, which I believe is up over 2,500 lines of the day now, right?
Mine more than that.
Do you read it every day?
No, I do not.
He doesn't know. He's lying.
I just said I don't read it, Dave.
Why don't you read it? You can sit and enjoy it. I find it fascinating. I'll read it to the kids when I'm trying to get them to sleep. Just real. Sometimes I'll even draw funny pictures with it. So I think this could make a children's book for kids that curse. So anyway, he says he sent me Ricky Gervais DVDs and Westboro Baptist Church DVDs. I, of course, don't get it. He rechecks it, post-signed for it. Now, this is the same thing that's happened with our friend Mooch, right?
Yes. It's happened a couple of times, but... And I don't know, things always seem to go into a black hole.
Yeah, I asked you to go look for it. You found it for me.
Yes, I did.
Where was it?
It was in the bookshelf over Dave's desk.
So you think what happened to it?
I just think that it just, like everything else in that office, when I tell them to clean the office, it just kind of got discarded and kind of tossed aside.
First of all, why would anybody take something that belongs to me and put it up somewhere in the office like it was storage?
I couldn't tell you. I mean, every time there's a piece of mail for any of us, I'm like, make sure they get it. Make sure there's a one sheet of someone, you know, make sure the person gets properly credited for it. Just not let it hang in the office too long.
And things are just the mail.
Who was behind that?
I would have to say Dave. Dave's in the office more than any of us.
I'm in the office doing work.
Poe hands that thing over when he signs for it, it's supposed to come to me.
I don't know what happened. I honestly thought that it had been put out there and had been taken. And if that's...
So you already knew about it?
I just knew about it this week, but now that you're talking about it, perhaps I remember putting it in the desk and then... I don't know. And I'll take responsibility for this one then.
Put that down till he steals from Ron.
You may need to do a follow-up email.
How about the Mooch one? Did you find that?
No, I never even heard
Mooch
about
said
that.
He sent me Rory Gallagher Live, which I would love to watch. Nope.
See, can I also just say this? Sometimes people sign for things, and then they just put them over my desk like that I'm
so
supposed to know.
So you're blaming Poe?
No, I'm not. Yeah, I am.
Then you need to find yourself on a daily basis checking in with Poe.
I'm going to start doing that.
How can you? You're already out of here if Wiki does his job.
I hope Don sees things differently.
Here is Paul. Paul, you're on Running Fest.
Hey, what's up, guys? Hey, Earl, listen, man. If you really think the corporate guys at XM are going to fire the little people down... Hello?
Yeah, you're not making any sense. What is it you want to say?
No, I just wanted to say that they're going to fire the top guy. I mean, he's responsible. He's accountable to even let this get to this level.
You know, the whole screening of phone calls has to mean to screen out the retards. That's what we mean when we say screen the calls. No bad calls. That's not too much. It's a Ron and Fez show. Here comes East Side Dave into the studio for the first time today. How are you, David?
I'm very good, thank you. I'm a little bit on edge because of some of the problems, and we all know what they are.
I have a email, too, that I'll be reading in a little bit that's come back from Wiki already, Fez.
Oh, quick response.
Yeah.
We actually got something from the Manhattan Sports Memorabilia Society for Fez.
Really?
They heard Fez talking about them.
Yeah.
And so they thought we'll chip in and get him something nice.
Yeah. Nice.
So,
I got a signed Babe Ruth ball, which is really just a Ron and Fez stress ball, and someone has scribbled the name Babe Ruth. They've printed Babe Ruth on it poorly.
I think that's from the Big Bambino.
They swore it was authentic.
Yeah.
It's not. These polymers weren't even invented when Babe Ruth was around, and these squishy balls.
Oh, yeah, I think they had that kind. Those are like pinkies.
He busted you on the polymers. That's how he was able to get to the bottom of that. Fezzi said that he loves Manhattan for the great restaurants and sports memorabilia.
Among other things.
All right, Ron and Fez show. Here is the email back. I'll read the email first that that Earl sent out to Wiki and in care of Eric Logan. So this one's going right to the top. I'd like to recommend that we replace David McDonald with Pepper Hicks, effective immediately. Since coming aboard as an intern, Pepper's brought a great passion and energy to the show. He's constantly coming in with ideas that work for the show on and off air. And boy, this sentence runs on. And he's willing to give his time, comma, no matter how long, comma, to any project. Let's see how many commas that he throws into things. Dave has been terrific on the air, but has lacked the administrative skills that are needed to make the show go to the next level. If you'd like to discuss this at length, please feel free to call me. So Wiki writes back to him, Earl, if you're so upset and dissatisfied with Dave, then why are we blowing $20K on this wedding? By the way, is there three S's and dissatisfied? The S's is just going like a snake showed up in the middle of this.
I don't believe so.
No, I'll admit the timing was pretty bad, but, I mean, hey, things came to a head today, and you got to make moves, you make the moves.
Hmm.
You may have to get married, Earl, to cover for this.
To who?
So how do you feel, how are you going to respond to this?
I will, you know, I'll sit back, I'll think about it for a minute.
Why don't you just write back this? What does one have to do with the other? Good one. Go ahead. Send it out. You might want to stop CC and ELO, though. That doesn't seem like the best idea for you.
Yeah, I mean, that's
kind of stupid.
Yeah, that wasn't very bright.
None of the stuff you do is bright at all. And remind him that you're the only black working here in the New York XM offices.
Keep playing that.
Well, until you get over to a certain trumpet player, and then forget it, Earl. All right, off you go.
All right.
Make it happen. Make it so. Here is Buck. Buck, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Yeah.
Hey, I just can't believe Earl's got the balls with all of his screw-ups administratively to call out Dave to his own boss. That's amazing to me.
Well, Earl is Dave's boss, though. I mean, if Dave had these skills, maybe we wouldn't figure out that Earl doesn't. And this is the first time ever I'm going against the PAC on something, Fez. I am going head-to-head with the PAC with this. And you may see me and Deb on Nightline.
All right. That means you're going to have to go ahead and debate her.
Oh, I feel comfortable with it.
Yeah?
I feel comfortable with it.
So the PAC, they'll defend just about anybody. Coming to Eastside Dave's defense.
Why aren't they defending Earl and what he's been through then?
Because Earl's part of the system.
That is true. Very good point. Earl and... Is this a tag out, Fez, where you don't even have to think anymore? People in other rooms are helping you? But, yeah, that is a good point, Fez and company. He is the man now. Earl has become the man. What are you checking on, Earl?
I thought my phone was ringing.
Anything new back from Wiki?
No, not yet.
When did you send him? Oh, you didn't send him back anything? let's see what you wrote back to him. I don't see what one thing has to do with the other. This has been coming to a head for a long time and needed to be addressed. Boy, you really did sell Dave out today on his wedding week. And you were in the wedding.
Yeah, I was a groomsman.
Are you going to be able to do something about this Pitsy situation until I hear him just jumping in against you? They don't respect you, Earl.
No, and, you know, that situation will be rectified very soon.
And neither do the new interns who say... That you never address them.
I have no idea. I address them. I say, good morning. How are you? I say, when they do something for me, I say, thank you.
But you don't give them direction.
I give them direction. I gave them several tasks last week, and they came in, and they gave them to me, and I said, thank you.
Who is the guy that you're more likely to learn from?
Pepper Hicks, actually.
Who's another intern?
Yeah, I've learned the most from Pepper Hicks. I've learned how to do best ofs. I've I'm learning to do show openers.
And who have you learned the least from?
I guess Earl. Well, like I asked him about that thing the other day, and he gave me that joke that he tried where he was saying...
I'll get a trade. All right, Nico, let the Velvet Underground come in. I see that he wants to be a little part of this. Velvet Underground, give us the person who gives you the most direction.
Pepper is really good. Because he's professional, but he's also, like, with us.
Yeah.
So it's good. So, yeah.
And least?
Earl.
What's the problem with Earl?
It's like a wall. It ignores us. It's like we don't exist.
I hardly ignore you.
But that's those guys saying that to me. That's not me saying it to them.
No, I understand that. Yeah. But I'm like, I don't ignore you. I appreciate everything you guys are bringing to
the
table.
But you would be like a sergeant, right, in the Army, going, look, I appreciate you guys. You have to lead them, Earl.
Yeah, and I, I'm a...
Do you feel like you're being led right now underground?
Nah, I mean, Pepper's leading me. Pepper, I'd say Pepper.
All right, so Pepper, this is a rogue
Sergeant
army.
Pepper, that's what we call it.
Yeah, Sergeant Pepper?
Sergeant Pepper.
I fucking love it. Who came up with that?
I just did right now.
All right, you're the best.
All right,
go ahead. Every time an underground kid comes in, not a home run, but he does get hit. He gets wood on the ball. Oh, God, look, this kid looked like he slept in his clothes last night. Would you get all fucked up, Rooster?
Yes, I did. In Prospect Park.
Are you starting to get around Brooklyn a little bit?
I'm starting to figure things out. It's getting a little easier.
Yeah. Who is the person you consider the leader?
I have to give it to either Eastside Dave or Pitsy. Both of them, since I've gotten here, have been extremely helpful.
Mm-hmm. And least?
Earl, I will dispute, has never told me good morning once.
Never once said good morning to you?
No.
This kid flew across the country to be here. Do you feel like you're getting the most out of your internship?
I feel, for the most part, but... Really,
I came over today, and you and Underground were staring out the window, and they were talking about, wouldn't it be weird to work construction? And I'm like, who is not keeping these kids busy? They should be on a full run at all times.
Yes, I mean, well, this morning was just...
Why don't you do this? Write another thing to Wiki and let them know you want to get rid of all the interns.
Well, I mean, they, you know, they haven't really... mouthed off to me. They made an opinion, which I respect. I don't necessarily agree with, but I respect
it. If you could only pick one person who's leading you the most, who would it be?
I'd have to give it to Eastside Dave.
Wow. First vote for the ex-employee of the show,
even
Eastside Dave.
Eastside Dave even took me out on Friday.
Where'd
bought
you guys
me dinner,
go?
Bought me drinks.
Was he fucked up?
He wasn't 100% clear-headed.
Now, I remember talking to him before. He wasn't allowed to drink with the interns, remember?
Yes. I totally remember that.
He had that direction.
Yes, I did. I mean, I was there where they took them out.
Where did he take you?
Someplace up the street. I'm not really sure what it was called.
Oh, yeah. One of his Irish bars?
Exactly. I believe that was right. Yeah.
We went to PJ's.
Mm-hmm.
And for the most part, yeah, he was just drinking cola. I was the one who had beer.
Yes. You are not allowed to drink.
Oh.
Not the interns. You're not allowed to be drunk with the interns. You were told that before.
I thought that had been lifted. So that was
why would it be?
I don't know. I thought that was with a few specific.
The only thing was when Bill got hired, then we said, okay, you can drink with Bill.
Okay, that was why I thought it had been lifted. So that's my mistake.
Boy, you have become... Earl, with the constant admitting to mistakes anymore.
Well, I'm admitting to... my responsibilities, where Earl likes to point the finger. So I think that's the difference between he and I.
Oh, no. He invented the line. I take full responsibility. Here is John. John, you're on manifest.
Hey, I respect Earl for trying to destroy his competition here, but it sounds like you should have gone after Pepper instead of Dave. Dave's going to self-destruct here. Pepper's the up-and-comer.
Do you start to hear the footsteps with Pepper?
I hear the footsteps. He's doing an unbelievable job.
But I heard Pepper yell at you today over the opening.
Well, again, it was so heated a moment. I was like, where is this opening? And he got a little upset. I mean, we were all a little upset over it.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I'm not a big yeller. I'm not a big screamer. I never have been.
I've heard you scream on here all last week.
Yeah, I mean, well,
when you and Dave has come to a head, there's nothing you can do about it anymore.
It takes me so
long. One of you has to leave.
Yes. I mean, and it takes me so long to really explode and really...
Do you think it would be better for the show, considering how much he adds to the on-air product, if you stepped down instead of asking Dave to step down?
No, I don't see that at all. I don't see me...
You honestly feel like you're a more valuable person to the show itself than Dave?
Yeah, I do. I really do.
Really? What do you do?
Well, production, I do...
What production gets done?
Well, I make sure that, you know, best ofs are coordinated.
Well,
and
speaking of that, people told me that want to tape the shows, your Friday best of, when it's midnight Friday night, everybody hears the Monday show, so they don't get the Friday replay.
Well, I had that exact conversation on, it was either Wednesday or Thursday, with Wiki about that, and he was
so
like,
"So this is Wiki's fault."
I don't even know if it's
next email. Wiki, follow yourself.
I don't know if it's a Wiki
start
fault
typing.
Or a DC fault, but I asked.
What
that
if
exact
you did something different rather than what you're doing now?
It's kind of Oliver Twist.
Brian, you're on a Fez.
Hey, Ronnie. You know, I'm lazy. I rarely tell the truth, and I was brought up with the Easter Bunny and Santa Claus, so I could take over for Earl easily. You know, I'm gullible. I believe everything, and I can deflect excuses all over the place.
Earl, how do you feel about that? The same point that they gave you your religion, they also told you about the Easter Bunny, Santa Claus, to help keep you in line.
We never were brought up on the Easter Bunny or Santa Claus. And, Brian, you got excellent comic timing also.
What is that? Why? Is this your Christian love that you have right now?
I'm paying him a compliment.
What's the compliment, Earl?
He has good timing.
You have the balls to sit around and judge somebody else's timing? You're a fucking producer. You should be able to know where the show is going and hit music and sound effects. You never fucking do it at all. You want to talk about timing? I'll fucking sit here and do an air check with you and point out all the things that could be added to this show. Now, the fucking guy was talking to you. Why do you have to attack every caller? If you attacked every 10th caller, I wouldn't give a shit. But you attack everybody who fucking calls this show.
The man did insult me.
He fucking did not. He said he came up with Santa Claus and the Easter Bunny like we all were. And at a certain point, you no longer believe what you were taught as a child. It's a fucking decent point. You could make your point instead of turning it into dog shit. That's why I can't fucking depend on you to jump into this show without it turning into you fucking screaming at people. What do you have for us? What do you have for us, Hicks?
I can give me 2 minutes. If
all right. This is a thing of the way Earl talks to callers. I'm telling you right now, Earl, this fucking 2 weeks vacation couldn't be coming any goddamn sooner for me. That you sit around and you say you worry about what happens on the show and you do the same thing fucking day after day.
Yeah, it's in one run.
Where's your fucking timing right now, Earl?
I apologize. I'm sorry.
I
took it as an insult. I apologize.
You take this fucking show as an insult.
No, that is not the case at all. But I thought he insulted me and I misinterpreted. I'm sorry.
All right, here's an example of Earl talking to people on the show.
You've completely fucked up the best ofs. I get the emails every day.
You know, and in
this
my...
This is who you are.
No, in my...
And Al was right. We have taken responsibility after responsibility away from you.
If you're sitting here listening to this channel all day, you really need more time.
You're a fucking asshole. They pay listen... To this channel.
They should
have programming at all times.
No, and I understand.
Maybe
at
NEW you used to attack the P1s. That's why you used to have a 1.9 there for 22 years. Well, that was inside. That was a fucking inside joke.
Here's more.
You know what? Now I'm not having fucking fun here anymore. Now I'm not fucking having fun. The last person to have fun is no longer. Now what do we do?
Yeah, find a way to have fun again.
Bullshit.
Again, I'm sorry. I'm totally sorry.
Earl, why this has to happen?
I don't want to fucking do this radio. I'm fucking sick of it.
Earl, why do you do this?
I thought the
why? Why do you fucking do this?
What the man? I was under the assumption he insulted me. And why? And when I get insulted, why can't I defend
fuck
myself?
You. I'm insulting you right.
So.
You can talk to.
Just Adam.
Are you insulted? Defend your fucking self.
And
now fucking defend yourself.
And I misinterpret that, and I apologize for that. I misinterpreted what he said, and I apologize.
Earl, I am being as honest as I can. You are fucking ruining this. You are fucking ruining this show.
You need to get it together, Earl.
You drive me absolutely insane. Why you add to the stress of things instead of helping alleviate it is beyond me.
It's the happiest show on earth, the Ron and Fez show. Ron Bennington, Fez Watley, Earl Douglas, all sitting in together. That got a little crazy.
Yeah. I'm sorry that it got that crazy. I'm a mess right now. I don't know what to think or say.
You know what? We're going to have to stop the wedding. The wedding has put too much pressure on all of us.
Yeah, it's been... The wedding, you know...
Call Wiki and tell them we went out of this wedding. And Dave and Casey will get married in a civil ceremony in Reno.
It sounds right for me. That makes everybody happy.
Well, except for Dave and Casey.
Well, they'll get married.
And Wiki, who's already spent the money.
And gotten the tablecloths and flowers together.
Ron and Fez.
What's that? Who's yelling our names out over there? Dave, what's going on there? If I take Earl out of that...
Sorry, the microphone hit. But I was going to say, I would hope the wedding would still go on, even though I do...
We're going to do this wedding. And then we're all going to take 2 weeks off.
And I apologize if it's made everyone insane.
No, we're not insane from that. It's always a pre-live gig weirdness. This one's been extra weird. It just seems to me we keep falling back into the same fucking inside shows day after day. And that 2002 shit really got on my nerves. To really fucking hear. Wait to hear the energy the show had 5 years ago. It's insane. This is the best fucking job I ever had in my life. And I do not understand why we don't show up and have fun for it.
I mean, it's... I love it. I mean, I love the work. I love what we do. I love the fact that we can...
I thought you said you were a Christian. You're going to go to hell for lying. You can't possibly love this job.
I do. I mean, as much as I question it sometimes, I'm like, it is the greatest job in the world. It is where you can be... Well, you can communicate to so many people on this format, to communicate across the country and to connect with people from California and Texas and
then why
truckers.
Do you scream at them? And why do you tell them not to listen to the channel?
Well, I needed
you got to stop talking like
I
that.
I understand. I mean, and that's just out of, you know, when I get angry, I'm just so...
It's a one-note thing, and that drives me crazy.
I get so angry because, I mean, especially when I'm completely insulted, or I'm thinking I'm getting insulted. I just, when I do lose my temper, I'm just completely irrational.
Remember what I told you before. When you lose your temper, break equipment.
I can't do that anymore, because the last time I did, I kind of got into trouble a little bit.
30 days in the hole.
Dave, how are you feeling about the whole wedding thing coming up? Stand by for what?
That's Pitts.
What is he screaming for?
He doesn't realize the radio show is going on.
Let me ask you this. How come this doesn't happen when Earl's in there?
It does happen sometimes, but obviously it's happened a couple times. I feel extremely nervous, mm-hmm. you know, and I'm filled with excitement at the same time. But I'm dying a little bit inside, and I'm also, you know, I feel nervous about everyone else's... where they are in their headspace. I'm talking Ron, Fez, Earl, Pepper, you know. I think everyone's a little on edge. But for me, for my wedding, I'm nervous as hell, to be honest with you. And I may faint, I don't know.
I don't think Casey should go through with this. And I was telling this to a friend of mine today, that I feel like, as a responsibility, I got to stop this girl from marrying this lunatic.
I don't think that's necessary. I think we're a good couple. And I don't think that people need to split us up. You know, I just think we need this day to be over in a little bit of a weird way. And then when it's over, we can go on with our lives.
How did we ever get to the fact of doing this on the air? How did this even start? I don't even remember. I don't remember how we get into things that we do.
Yeah, I have no idea where we got to wedding day tomorrow at the Hard Rock.
Why are you guys getting married? You just met a few months ago.
Well, we have a connection. I mean, you know, it's pretty obvious that we don't want to be with anyone else and that we do love each other.
Hmm.
We can live together.
Sure? We like the same things.
Like what?
you know, Star Wars action figures and...
Hey, Earl's here.
Figures. Mm. And baseball. Friday the 13th movies. Yeah, I could go on and on.
You sound like you want to marry a 10-year-old boy. That would be perfect for you.
It doesn't seem like an awful lot to build a life on.
No, no. She and we also talk about deeper things.
Like?
Israeli-Palestine conflict, for one. You know.
Let me guess whose side she's on.
Yeah, you
it's
would.
It's the only place her and Bam ever come together.
Right. You would guess correctly. Mm. You know, I agree with her standpoint. So we do a little bit of that, and
you along with 90% of the U.S.
Yeah,
so you could marry 90% of the U.S. right
now. Oh, okay, and you know, other things, George Bush and some of his policies.
Let me guess, you're against him?
No, I just, you know, I'm not familiar with all of his stuff, but I know that it doesn't look good. You know, I would say his favorability is like 33%. So.
Favorability?
We're talking about your marriage.
Okay.
Now you're talking about poll numbers on the president.
I'm just saying this is what we talk about. But besides that, yeah, no, there's a real connection. I mean, there's, you know, we like to hug a lot, too. Mm. And there is no one else that I'd rather be
is
with.
Is this going to your vows? Are we stepping all over your vows?
No, this has nothing to do with the vows.
Did you rewrite the vows from yesterday?
Yes, I did.
Are they better?
I think so. I could show them to you if you don't say them on the air.
Yeah, show them to me. Bring them in. Yesterday he read it before us, just horrible. And we said, you cannot do this. You cannot do this.
I mean, he wrote them like this. It sounded like, you know, like I really, 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 like when you were 10 years old. And you had
childlike.
You had to write an essay.
All right, we got a copy of the vows. This is what Eastside Dave and... Several failed attempts over the past 2 days while you've been practicing.
Well, let me just say this. This is very personal.
Yeah, I took your advice. Thank you. I tried to make it as personal as I could.
I would literally, if I was her, I'd turn around and run.
Uh-oh.
Why? There's a lot of nice stuff in there and a lot of accurate information. And
yeah, it is.
Does it look like it should be put together with clipped out letters from magazines? Like a serial killer letter?
I don't think it does. I think it's sweet, no? Or you know what? I don't know how to write a vow. I mean, I've never... Roman Catholic, they usually just do the...
Yeah, they do it normally
for
you.
I'll take you my lawfully lutted...
You're lawfully lutted?
My lawfully loved wife.
Oh, we forgot to have Casey lutted before tomorrow.
And they do it like that, so... I've never... my brothers didn't write their own vows, so... It's going to be an experience.
Yeah. One point here, I thought this was, you ripped it off from Lou Gehrig. There is a certain point here that's very Gehrig.
I did the,
Here's, I'm going to guess Powell, because I can't tell with the, see the way the writing's on here today. Yeah, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, guys, how's it going?
Yeah.
Hey, Ronnie, I don't mean to beat up Earl. He's been taking a lump in today, but the guy seems to really know his music. Why is he a producer on a talk show and not 60 other, you know, music channels on XM, which is baffling.
Earl, what do you say about that? Why didn't you get in the music business? That seems to be your thing.
I love the show. I completely, as a listener, I fell in love with the show. And
me too.
I had a, I mean, I thought I had the best seat in the house because when you guys started in New York, I was the show. I ran the show in front of you.
Right.
So I got to see the show just go off and running, and then you can't help but fall in love with the show.
The Al Dukes years?
Yeah, no, I mean, that was actually pre-Al.
Mm. We call that pre-cum. Here's Scott, you're on Fez.
Holy shit, guys. Stand by. Eastside Dave has found the perfect ingredients for a wedding. Discussing the favorability of the president, Star Wars action figures, and hugging a lot.
We're going to leave those topics off for the actual ceremony.
Now, she's writing you something too, right?
Yeah. Yeah, she's writing me something special. We always have nice conversations about our favorite bands, you know, how she's into The Clash and I'm into The Smithereens. And
but I thought Jonathan and her share more music knowledge than you do.
Yes, they do. They like the more independent stuff. I like the more Main Street stuff, the Jersey Rock, the Bruce, Bon Jovi, you know, Pat DiNuzio.
What?
And other bands, Southside Johnny.
Pat DiNuzio from
the Smithereens.
Smithereens, yeah.
I'll talk about that, and then she'll talk about her bands. She's always about the...
Smithereens, I forgot all about them. When were they big?
Oh, 89. Yeah. They were huge.
Yeah.
Girl Like You was like fucking out of this world.
It was a good song.
No, it was really awesome.
Yeah.
And I play it for her, and believe it or not, that's one of the few bands I play for her that she likes.
Really?
Yeah, she's actually very much
into it. So she's not into your Styx Journey Can? This is a song I want to play for you. It's called Cold as Ice. Listen to what he's saying to her. This Foreigner is the name of the band. Whether you ever heard of them. But you're as cold as ice.
Yeah.
Willing to sacrifice.
So that's our one common ground, you know. I can't even get her into the Beatles. She's not.
Here you go. Pretty.
You're as cold as ice.
Very nice. Is this what she's walking down the aisle to? Do we have all the music worked out, Earl?
Yes.
I want to go for that Sly Stone, Don't Call Me Whitey song. That's my... Or at least when you and I walk out together.
No.
What are you coming down the aisle to? Sniffing the tears? What do you have inside?
No, I'm just going to be there.
No.
You know, I'm not sure if the guy goes down the aisle or not.
No. The guy waits up. Yeah. I would say by the altar, but in your case, near the hamburger grill. You'll stand.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Stand under the giant 714 model.
Right. Well, I mean, we wouldn't be in front of an altar anyway, being that she's a Jew.
They don't have altars?
Boy, the way you say it sounds so respectful.
Jewish person. Yeah. We're allowed to say that. That's not politically correct.
Whose way? The other side?
No, but I'm married.
How are you going to raise the kids?
Agnostic.
That's a nice compromise.
Children, I want you to know we have no idea who God is. It's like, did you ever hear when people are like, we're going to let the children pick their own religion? I'm like, well, that's not too much fucking pressure now, is it? I have to come up with existence.
If I had that as a kid, I'd just be worshiping Hulk Hogan.
Well, that is based on the mythology.
He is the immortal Hulk Hogan.